Good morning, good morning, good morning, my loves. How are you doing this morning? I hope all is well with you. I hope you have a wonderful and awesome day. And honey, I hope you partied your butts off last night. Last night was Halloween. Last night was fun. The energy was good. I loved it. I stayed in the house. I didn't go anywhere. I didn't do anything. And I was just as happy with that because I had other things to do. But as far as me going out and partying, no, I wasn't in the mood this year. So I didn't. I didn't. But I might do something for today because today is the day of the dead. Dos Little Muertes. Oh, my God. I'm going to get that right. I said I was going to get it right in the last video. So I'm going to work on that today. But yes, this is the day of our ancestors, honey, that we celebrate them and the life that they lived here on this earth, okay? All right. This reading is going to be for Divine Feminine. Divine Feminine, this is your daily love reading. Welcome, 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 welcome. Come on in. Okay, we're going to get a theme for your reading. We're going to get a leading energy, a supporting energy, and then bust off into the tarot, okay? All right, my loves. Now, please keep in mind that this reading is general, the energies are fluid, and the message is timeless. Let's rock. Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit. What is the thing for divine? You got a lot going on, girl. You got a lot going on. And look at, please don't mind my nervous laugh. Because when you have a lot going on in love, it's not funny. But it made me a little nervous. Yeah, you have a lot going on. I can feel the energy already. But let's rock. Holy Spirit. Let's kick it out. Thank you. We have a flipper. We have a flipper. Okay. And then we have fear. Oh. Here we go with fear. Okay. All right. So there's something that you're fearing. Something that you need to release. You need to release the fear. Okay, and then we have the void. Damn. I hope my lighting is okay, but damn, Divine Feminine. Okay, I see why you're fearing, because there's something here that is, what you call that? You're in that shadow phase. Thank you. You're doing some shadow work here. Uh-huh. You're being protected. I don't know if you could see that. I hope you can. But you're being protected from this fear that you have. Okay? Or you're protecting yourself from this fear. It's making me feel like what people say, messages, comments, emails, texts, things of the sort. It's like they're trying to get in your head. Yeah. But you know what? You got control over this. You got control over all these bird motherfuckers around you trying to talk about you, say something to you, something of the sort like that. This is unnecessary. Okay? And with this void energy, it's making me feel like you pull back. Okay? This is very dark here. So it could be a very dark space and time in your life right now that a lot of people all in your ear about what you should do, what you gonna do, what you could do. Something of the sort. This feels like gossip. That's why I said it feels unnecessary, all of this chaotic energy around you. But it's something that you want to protect, either yourself or something inside of you that needs protection, because it's fear out here. It's busy. People are busy, okay? And it feels like a whole bunch of bird motherfuckers all in your business, always talking about you and your relationship, things of the sort, okay? Yeah. You know. You know what this also too feels like, Divine Feminine? That inner child. Something could have happened in childhood that you're protecting yourself from now. So I don't know if it's like a mindset, a way you act, the way you talk, the way you believe. A thing, something of the sort. Something happened. And it puts some type of fear in your energy that you do not want to. It's like you're protecting that because it hurts. Let's keep moving, because that's kind of difficult. And I'm trying to get it out. But there, that fear is, it's been there for a while. It's been there for a while. Okay. All right. Let's keep going. Holy Spirit. What else can you tell me? Oh, let's get a leading energy. Holy Spirit, let's get a leading energy for my divine feminines. Self-protection is what I heard. Okay. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Can you pick it out? They want me to cut and pull. Okay. Let's get one more. Thank you. Let's cut and pull. Okay. That's enough. Friendships, partners, and alliances is here. Okay. Like I said, it feels like a whole bunch of bird motherfuckers. I mean, and I can't... please forgive me for saying it like that, because that's what it is. It feels unnecessary. It could be a friendship that you are in. And it feels like an agreement. Okay? Yeah. This feels like an agreement. Maybe you... It feels like you feel like you hooked up with the wrong person. Y'all was friends first, and then it blossomed into something else, and now it has become something that you're not familiar with. Okay? All right. Let's keep moving. Holy Spirit, what's the supporting energy? What is the supporting energy of the leading energy, please? Oh, okay, we'll take that when they try to jump. At the bottom of the deck, we have prosperity begins. Okay, that's beautiful. I like that. Okay. And then we have awaiting results. This making me feel like there's a friendship that you open up to, but there is some type of childhood fear within yourself that is keeping this friendship, the connection, from blossoming. It's like you're stopping yourself here with this awaiting results and fear. Yeah, you're waiting to see what's going to happen, because there's a void in your life that you have to fill, or that you have to go through, or that you have to heal. Okay? It's making me feel like something childhood, or something that happened in your childhood, that it embedded some type of fear in you. And what I mean by this fear, it's like it's not letting you be the true person that you are meant to be because of this fear. Okay? You do have people around you that want to help you either get through this, understand this, but it's like it's too much chatter. It's too much extra stuff that's going on around you that is stopping you or blocking you from blossoming. Okay? Yeah. And look, the divine feminine abundant prosperity begins. Okay, so you have a lot of abundance around you or in you, but it's this fear baby. This is something that you've been carrying for a while, and it's very hard to break away from that. It's too many people talking and chattering around you, and it's like you're protecting this fear more and more. I don't know if it's fear of what happened in your childhood, fear of a secret coming out, fear of somebody really knowing exactly who you are and how you operate, something of the sort, okay? Something of the sort, but it is stopping you from connecting and growing within yourself or with other people, okay? All right, let's see. What do I want to use? Well, we're going to use these again, okay? We're going to use these again. Let's see. Oh, let's see. Okay. We'll use the witch's tarot as well. Boom. All right, Holy Spirit. What message do you have? What message do you have? You know what? This is also too. you have a group of people around you that is helping you through this. So it could be like a counseling set, a counseling session group, you know, group therapy, like people that have been through the same thing that you've been through, something of the sort. Support group. Thank you, Holy Spirit. I can't get it out. Support group around you. This is for some of you guys, okay? To help you get work on this fear, this embedded fear that you have within yourself. I don't know if it's a fear of becoming, a fear of letting people know exactly how you feel, how you think, something of the sort. But you gotta let it go. And it's taking up unnecessary space. Okay. Oh my goodness. I'm gonna keep it. We have the King of Swords right here. Very intelligent as your first energy's out. I love it. Sometimes the King of Swords could overthink a thing. Okay, but very intelligent. Okay, a great communicator too. So there's some type of decision that you have to make, ahead of a hard decision that has been made, or that you're gonna have to make here. But you're using your best judgment here. This also too giving me the power of discernment here. What you need to say, what you need to do in order for you to move forward here. I heard you're getting the help that you need in order for you to heal something that happened in your childhood here. It's making me feel like you're gonna have to do this before love comes. And look, here go the King of Cups here. Here come love. Yeah, two kings here. Okay, so this is also two self-mastery here, being your first energies out. But I will say, Divine Feminine, when two kings pop out back to back like that, it's making me feel like that's that masculine energy that is around you, that is trying to help you get through something. It's making me feel like childhood trauma here, okay? But it's two people, two masculine energies that is, I heard, biting for your attention. Oh, my God. It's chatter around you. That's what I'm saying. This energy is two people that's either you could be talking to two people or two masculines, or it's people talking about you and these two masculines or something of the sort. Something of the sort. I mean, and one of them could be an air sign. One of them could be a water sign. Air sign Cancer. Ooh, sorry. Water sign is Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. Air sign is Aquarius, Libra, Gemini. So they could be one of those signs. That's that chatter. Okay, let's keep going. This is self-mastery as well. And look, here go the Queen of Swords. You have the King and Queen of Swords out here. It's too many people. These are people. That's what I'm saying. It's a lot of chatter. It's like a lot of people is either in your business, talking about your business, talking about you and your business, something of the sort. Okay? That's for some. But for others, baby, you married to this King of Swords. You're coming up as the Queen of Swords. I would say married in the 5D. For some of you guys, you haven't been able to manifest that in the 3D, but you know who your life partner is. You know the person that you match intellectually with. Okay, this is somebody that y'all meshed together, okay? But then you have this King of Cups dead smack in the middle of you two. This is outside energy. Honey, boom. Is somebody trying to interfere with you and your person? Another masculine energy. Now, the masculine could be feminine or male, but they operating in their masculine energy, and it's making me feel like they're trying to come in between you and your person to break you up so that they can collect. Okay, that's what they said, collect. Okay, partnerships and alliances, waiting results. I'm telling you, baby, it's messy here. it's messy. It's too many people in your business. That's what I keep picking up. And you have three court cards coming out as your first energies. This is too many people in your business, or too many players, too many people involved in a situation here. I'm just saying. It's too much. Let's keep going, Holy Spirit. Oh, God. Okay. Well, you just gonna throw them out my hand. Go ahead with yourself. Here we have the Ace of Swords. Clear communication, victory, and success. You telling the truth is what I'm hearing. We have the Two of Swords. Okay. This is blocking energy here. Blocking energy here with the Three of Swords. Okay, I see now. We have the Nine of Pentacles. We have the Two of Wands. And we have the Seven of Pentacles. You trying to weigh out your options, Divine Feminine. Uh-huh. You trying to weigh out your options. And you probably getting advice from any and everybody that listen to what you have to say because you're going through it right now. Because there's a choice and a decision that you have to make between two people. And you're weighing out your options. Okay? This also, too, you could be going to family and friends, you know, getting advice, something of the sort. That's that support group I picked up on. Uh-huh. And they talking. They talking. Uh-huh. Or this is you telling everybody that want to listen about your dilemma. Okay? The Two of Swords and the Ace of Swords is the Three of Swords. Whatever decision that you're going to make, Divine Feminine, somebody's going to walk away heartbroken. Either you, this King of Air, or this King of Water. Okay, this is not going to be no polygamy relationship or polyamorous relationship, or however you want to say it, no. Uh-uh. There ain't going to be no secret lovers in here either. There's a decision that will be made, and once somebody is going to leave heartbroken. That's what's here. This is the fear energy that you're in. Fear and outcome of a thing. Protection. You want to protect yourself because you don't want to be heartbroken, but you know somebody will end up heartbroken after you make this decision here. Okay, but somebody is trying to come in between you and your person here. Uh-huh. This is another option for you, Divine Feminine here. Uh-huh. Oh. That's for some of you guys. For others, this is another option for your person here. That's trying to come in between the two of you. This feels like somebody who's operating in their masculine energy. I'm going to say this and I'm going to say it once. It could be another man or a woman. But that if it's a woman, that woman is operating out of her masculine energy. If it's a man, damn. Y'all need to talk. Shit. What's at the bottom of the deck? Eight of Cups. Walking away from people, places, and things emotionally. You in a predicament. Divine Feminine, you have choices to make that is very life-changing here. Look, walking away from a family dynamic or something that was very stable here. Or you're walking away from people, places, and things in order to go to this Ten of Pentacles energy here. And here we have another King up under the deck. Got choices and options, girl. You got choices and options. Who are you going to invest in? And when I say somebody is going to be heartbroken, it's because somebody is walking away from this emotionally here. Okay? This is where that heartbreak is going to come in. It's making me feel like Divine Feminine. You don't want that heartbreak to be on you, but you don't know exactly what to do or how to have the best outcome in this connection, but we're gonna clarify. Damn, Divine Feminine, you're in a predicament. You're in a little pickle here. What are you gonna do? It's making me feel like you're tired, or you don't want to make this choice. Oh, I heard your spirit of choice have been made, but you don't want to. It's like you know what you want to do, but you're scared to do it. You know what you want to do, but you're scared to do. You're scared of the outcome of what you're going to do. I picked this up last night. I picked some of this energy up last night. Okay. All right, Holy Spirit. Let's clarify the King of Swords, but I will tell you, you will make a head over heart decision when it comes to this predicament that you find yourself in, Divine Feminine. You will make a head over heart decision. What's the King of Swords? Let's clarify. Can you pick it out? No? Okay. One more? Okay. Sometimes Holy Spirit say no. Shoot. We have the Seven of Swords. Look at this here. The lying, cheating, and sneaking around. Somebody think they getting away with something. Somebody think they oh so smart. I hope this ain't you, Divine Feminine. Page of Cups at the bottom of the day. Somebody got a new love. You sneaking around. Or this is somebody about you. But this is somebody that's trying to come in between the middle of your relationship. And you're sneaking. This is a cheating energy here. But a decision will be made. And somebody is going to walk away heartbroken. Damn. Let's clarify the King of Cups. Yeah, somebody think they oh so smart. Thinking it because they sneaking and cheating. This is the person you're probably walking away from. If this is not you, Divine Feminine, you're going to end up walking away from this King of Swords energy, and you're going to leave them heartbroken, or you're going to be walking away heartbroken because they were sneaking around. This is your fear right here. This is a child. This is a child involved. Okay. I'm so sorry, Divine Feminine. If this is being done to you, I am so sorry. If you're doing this, get your shit together. If you are doing this, get your shit together, Divine Feminine. If this is being done to you, I am oh so sorry. Let's clarify this King of Cups. That's why people are talking. This is probably why you're going around trying to get advice here, because your person is sneaking around on you. This is for some of you, Divine Feminists. Let's get one more. Thank you. Look, the Eight of Wands. This is a movement energy. This is also, too, information coming into you. This is somebody that's moving towards you. Two of Pentacles. Divine Feminine, you cheating. I'm going to tell you to your face like this. You're cheating. This king of water is coming towards you. You're communicating with this King of Water while you're sneaking around on this King of Swords. The Two of Pentacles is at the bottom of the deck. This is a juggling energy. Let me clean that up a little bit, because everybody's not a cheater, but you're entertaining two options. Boom. You're entertaining two options here, Divine Feminine. If you're not, then this is not your reading. Just like that. If you're not entertaining two options, this is not your reading. This is why I said when the decision will be made, somebody is going to walk away heartbroken. Let's clarify this Queen of Swords here. Holy Spirit. You know what? My lighting is so horrible. Look, the Three of Swords, I told you. It's making me feel like it's you going to be walking away heartbroken here. Okay? Or you're going to cause this heartbreak. I heard you, Spirit. You're going to cause this heartbreak. Oh, Divine Feminine, what your ass doing? Look, the Page of Cups at the bottom of the deck. Yep, you're going to cause a heartbreak. You had a Seven of Swords and the Three of Swords, which is the Ten of Swords, which is an ultimate betrayal here. It's making me feel like you're jumping from one connection to another. Yeah. I don't know if you feel like the other connection is better here. Okay, but you're still connected to somebody and you're entertaining somebody else, Divine Feminine. If you're not doing this is not your reading. Or if you're not doing this is being done to you. If this is being done to you, I'm oh so sorry. But your person is cheating, lying, and sneaking around on you. If this is you, you need to get your shit together and make a decision. Let's keep going. The truth will come out. This is the Ace of Swords. The truth will come out. Let's rock. Holy Spirit, what can you tell me about the Ace of Swords? Oh, goodness, baby girl. Look it. You have the Ace of Pentacles in reverse. You have the Ace of Pentacles in the reverse. This is a big... This could be a loss of some type of... That's a loss. It could be financial loss. It could be material loss. But this is the, when the truth come out, you're going to lose a lot. Or this person's going to lose a lot. If you're the one that's sneaking around doing the cheating, you're going to lose a lot. If your person is doing the running around, sneaking and cheating, they're going to lose a lot. And this, with the Ace of Swords, it's the truth. It's the truth. This is the God honest truth. And it's in the upright. I heard lost opportunity here. The Ace of Swords is an abundant opportunity from the Most High. When the truth come out, this is going to be a lost opportunity that's going to cost a whole lot. Look, the Emperor at the bottom of the deck. A king with no kingdom. Or a queen with no queendom. I'm just saying. Damn. It's Divine Feminine. It really feels like this is you entertaining two options here. Let's keep going. Holy Spirit, Holy Angels. Dang, Divine Feminine. You're going to have to make a choice, but I'm going to tell you, if you're sneaking around entertaining two people, it's not going to work out at all. Let's clarify the Two of Swords, please. You're going to have to release one in order to go towards another here, babe. Yeah. Now, the other way you're going towards, or the one that's coming towards you, is the better. It's a more loving option. This person is more loving, more caring, more compassionate. More so than than your person that you're with now. They're very cold and cutting and direct. This other person that's coming towards you is very relaxed, very loving, compassionate, a little bit sensitive, you know what I mean? But they could be hiding their emotions here as well because they're so in control. They're controlling their emotions. So they're probably not telling you as much how much they're into you right now until, you know, you guys get to know each other a little bit more. Okay? But, Yeah. One is more compassionate than the other, and the other one is more direct and controlling than the other, okay? It's like a vast difference, the void. It's like a vast difference between the two, okay? All right, let's get the Two of Swords. We have the Eight of Swords. Two of Swords, Eight of Swords, Ten of Swords. Okay? Stuck in thought, okay? Feel like you're stuck. This is mental here. Can't make a decision, that's what I'm saying. And then we have the Hermit. Yeah, a lot of stuck, a lot of blocking energy here. You're blocking yourself from making a decision here. Okay, you're gaining enlightenment here, but there is fear. The Eight of Swords and the fear energy, this is fear of a decision that has to be made. The Eight of Swords and the Two of Swords is the Ten of Swords. So there is some type of heavy betrayal. Oh. Damn, they say heavy betrayal here. You're going to have to be very discerning in your actions that you take, Divine Feminine. Yes, you are. It's like you want to take a leap of faith towards somebody, but you're fearing the outcome of it. Yep, that's here. Let's see what this Nine of Pentacles is. Holy Spirit, clarify the Nine of Pentacles. This is an independent energy. I want to say it's a free spirit energy here. It could be coming from this King of Cups that's coming towards you, Divine Feminine. Very independent, this one here. Yeah, or this is you wanting to free yourself from a connection that you're already in order to go towards or move towards this King of Cups. Yeah. What is this? Two of Swords come flipping out in the reverse. Your mind is made up. Uh-huh. This is unblocking here. It's, I heard freeing. That's what I said. This feels freeing. It's Seven of Cups. Six of Cups at the bottom of the deck. Yeah. When this King of Cups comes towards you, it's going to be freeing. It's you're going to be unstuck. You're going to see what it is that you need to see in order to make a decision here. Now we have 222 here. Divine Feminine. There is another connection that is becoming available to you. that's making me feel like that's the better connection, but you're going to have to disconnect from who you're involved with, either energetically or physically first, in order for you to move forward towards a new connection properly and successfully. If you don't, you will lose and lose big. If you're sneaking around, cut it out. Make that decision. You cannot have your cake and eat it too, not when it comes to the matters of the heart. And there's heartbreak out here twice. The Ace of Pentacles is in the reverse. If this being done to you, baby girl, I am oh so sorry, but you're going to have to make a decision to leave that one alone. And once you make that decision to leave that one alone, boom, here come your King of Cups. Okay? All right, Holy Spirit, let's clarify the Two of Wands. Let's clarify the Two of Wands, please, and thank you. One more. Thank you. We have the Strength energy. Leo energy is here. You have to find the strength within yourself to make a decision. This is what I'm saying. If this is being done to you in the world, you're going to have to find the strength in order for you to close out a cycle so you can move forward. Like I said, Divine Feminine, if this is being done to you, I'm oh so sorry, but you're going to have to find the strength within yourself to sever that connection. And once you do, boom, here come your King of Cups. If this is you doing this, you need to cut the shit and make a decision, or else you will lose any and everything. You're going to be the one that's heartbroken and losing a lot. Okay? All right, let's clarify the Seven of Pentacles, please. Let's clarify the Seven of Pentacles. Divine Feminine, you're looking at me. You're looking at me. You know what needs to be done. Uh-huh. Yep. Fear of an outcome of a decision. This is why you're in that void energy. It's like, I heard lost in space. So you could be spacing out a lot. You know, just overthinking things, always in your head about a decision or an action that needs to be taken. Okay? All right. One more, Holy Spirit. Thank you. Appreciate you. And we got a Five of Swords. Mind games, bullshit, and fuckery. What's at the bottom of the deck? We have the Nine of Pentacles. This is a freeing energy. I heard free spirit as well. This, and you know what? All this is mind games, bullshit, and fuckery. This is ending your reading, and I agree. It's just too much. Like I said, it's too much going on. It's too much unnecessary energy. It's feeling like chatter. You know, gossiping, talking about these bird mother. Too much. Too many people in your business as well. Are you either involving too many people in your business, or are they actually inviting themselves into this? Into your energies, because they got something to say about what's going on with you. It's making me feel like behind the scenes here. But you're going to have to find the strength and courage within yourself to move forward if this is happening to you. If you're doing this, you're going to have to find the strength and courage to cut this shit out and make a decision. But there is a whole bunch of mind games, bullshit, and fuckery that is going on in this reading, Divine Feminine. Okay? All right, I'm going to jump out of this energy. I'm going to leave it right here. But Divine Feminine, this is what I have for you. So if you have a decision between the two to make, please make it. And don't be sneaking around with this one, trying to have your cake and eat it too. And if this is being done to you, make the decision to get out of it and move forward. Okay? All right, my loves. I hope you guys have a wonderful day, and I will see you in the next video. Till then, take care. Bye.